In this video, we'll start with the permanent tissues. In permanent tissues, the power of division is lost except for parenchyma cells. So we'll first see which type of permanent cells are there, and then we'll come to the various differences amongst them. So first is parenchyma. And in permanent tissue, we are talking about only the filling part, because epidermal tissue will take up when we talk of tissue system. So here we are talking about the ground tissue cells, which are parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. So parenchyma cells, they are thin walled. Thin wall means they have primary and secondary wall. If you remember, when we were talking about meristematic cells, we said only primary cell wall is present. But in case of parenchyma, primary and secondary walls have only cellulose and hemicellulose. There is nothing else which is deposited. These cells are isodimetric. That means all the sides are almost of the same size. The shape is also variable. They can be oval, round, hexagonal, or polygonal. That means if it is hexagonal, then all six sides are of same length. Such type of cells are present. Normally, they are loosely arranged and they have intercellular spaces. So, intercellular spaces are normally visible, are present. Then after understanding the structure, then we'll come to the function. If we are drawing these parenchyma cells and say we are drawing the rounded or the oval ones, then this is how the parenchyma cells would look. The wall is thin, the intercellular space is also visible. Intercellular spaces are also visible. So, this is how we draw parenchyma. If we have to draw it polygonal or hexagonal, then this is how the cell is going to be. Here also we will see this intercellular spaces. So, but normally this is how we draw parenchyma. Now, coming to the functions of parenchyma and its location. Function, it acts as a temporary storage cell. That means it can store few things for a short period of time. Second function, they may have chloroplast. So if chloroplast is present, then they perform photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is function, but for that, it should have chloroplast. Now, if parenchyma has chloroplast, then that parenchyma is known as chlorenchyma. Parenchyma, we can divide it into two types. Chlorenchyma, this is parenchyma where chloroplasts are present. So with chloroplast. And if chloroplast is there, that means there is this pigment, green pigment chlorophyll. So it will help in photosynthesis. So this could also be the function. Another function is they can act as secretory cells. Secretory function is also seen in case of parenchyma cells. Now coming to the location. So these are the functions. Now if we talk about the location, where can we find this parenchyma? One very important location is the cortex part. Cortex of stem and root. This is one place where we find parenchyma cells. The second location is mesophyll cells. Mesophyll cells means between the upper and the lower epidermis of leaf, there are parenchymatous cells. If you are able to recall the structure of leaf, we normally draw the upper epidermis, lower epidermis where we draw the stomata, and we show parenchyma cells arranged in two different ways. Just below the upper epidermis, here is the vascular bundle. The parenchyma cells are compactly packed. This is known as palisade parenchyma. And towards the lower side, they are loosely packed. So we call it spongy parenchyma. This is palisade parenchyma. And this one is known as spongy parenchyma. That means this is all parenchyma, but it is with chloroplast, so it is performing photosynthesis or helping in photosynthesis. The next type of parenchyma is with air spaces. That is known as aeronchyma. Aeronchyma is with air spaces. And these air spaces would help in providing buoyancy. It would help the plant to float. And that is why this particular type of parenchyma is found in, it is found in aquatic plants, so that these plants are able to float. So this is what we need to understand about parenchyma. Their thin wall cells, shapes are also variable. Intercellular spaces are very distinct. Temporary storage, photosynthesis, secretory can be the functions. And the location is cortex of stem root and in the leaf. Now we will discuss the second type of tissue, that is cholenchyma. This is chlorenchyma. Parenchyma with chloroplast is called chlorenchyma. The next one which we are talking about now would be cholenchyma. Let us now take the second type of the ground tissue, that is cholenchyma. In cholenchyma, the cells are again oval, rounded, or hexagonal polygonal. Suppose we make the cells as hexagonal polygonal, then the cells are going to look like this. But in cholenchyma, what happens is there is deposition of pectin. That means along with cellulose and hemicellulose, there is pectin deposition. And the pectin gets deposited more towards the edges or towards the corners. So if pectic material gets deposited here at this corner and this corner, same thing is going to happen here at this corner, corner of this cell and corner of this cell. Same thing here. So ultimately what is happening is the intercellular spaces are lost because of this deposition. Intercellular spaces are lost. Whereas when we made parenchyma, how was parenchyma? It was loosely arranged cells and we were able to see those intercellular spaces. So if we just draw it in a correct manner, we can distinguish between the different types of cells without even labeling anything. So now we have these two cells in front of us, and if we see intercellular spaces, then that is parenchyma. And if the intercellular spaces are filled up because of some substance, then that is cholenchyma. But because of this deposition also, or in spite of this deposition, cholenchyma still remains living cells. So parenchyma is also living. Here, though there is deposition of pectic material, but the deposition is only at the corners. And exchange of substances can take place through the wall, which is still being shared. So these cells are living cells. Exchange of substances and all those things or processes take place. Now, location. Location is very important in case of this cholenchyma. Because of this pectic material and the intercellular space is being filled, it provides mechanical strength. So, one location is, it is found at the base of the petiole. This is the petiole of the leaf, and here the tissue which would be found is going to be colenchyma. It is going to provide strength, and at the same time it is going to provide flexibility. So the function which we would write mechanical tissue, and it is living. We have to remember, it is a living mechanical tissue. The next tissue which we would be discussing is sclerenchyma, that is dead mechanical tissue. So it is living mechanical tissue. It provides flexibility. Now, how is this flexibility important? When the wind blows, the leaves, they flutter. So when the leaf moves, it moves from the base. This is the point from where it is going to move. But in spite of the wind being very strong, the leaves don't fall off. Same thing happens with the fruit. So second location is, if this is the fruit, even though if wind is blowing, raw fruits do not fall on their own. When they mature, then the fruits fall off, because here abscisic layer is formed. So why is the fruit not falling in spite of being moved due to this wind? Because it is moving, here is a flexible tissue. So this flexible tissue provides mechanical strength as well as this flexibility. So leaves and the fruits, they do not fall off. So these are two important locations. Third important location is for colenchyma. It is found in the hypodermis of dicot stems. We will talk about this point again when we come to the structure of dicot stem. So just below epidermis, there is a layer which is called hypodermis, and in dicot stem, that hypodermis is colenchymatous. One more function, sometimes they may have chloroplast and may perform photosynthesis. So these are the important functions of colenchyma. So these are two of the permanent cells which come in the category of ground tissue. That is the filling cells or filling tissue. Parenchyma and colenchyma, both are living. Both are thin walled. The walls have cellulose, hemicellulose. In case of colenchyma, pectin is deposited, and depending upon what structure they have, they are going to perform different functions, like the function of parenchyma and colenchyma. Now, in the next part, we'll be talking about the third type of tissue, that is sclerenchyma.